everybody. I'm Will Davis. Long time no see. This is my friend David Hookstead, and this is my
better friend,
equal friend Jenna Green. And today I will be moderating a debate between these two crazy kids about what matters more.
Crazy young guns.
Or to what degree they do matter. Muscle or money?
Okay. When it comes to relationship.
When it comes to relationship and when it comes to men attracting women. So I'll exit the stage, and since ladies first, I'll let Jenna
go ahead and accept ladies first.
Another hilarious joke from a member of the opposite sex.
All right. I would just like to go on record and specify that when this argument began, it was not muscles
versus
money.
It began 20 seconds ago, and he introduced it.
Right. No, this has been a long time coming. We had an argument about this at like 9 a.m., like guns blazing bright and
early. What are you talking about?
It started.
I don't. The debate started 20 seconds ago.
30 seconds.
Okay.
Go with your point.
Yeah,
muscles or money?
We'll cut that. Okay, that was not how the argument began. It was, is it more important for guys to have muscles or not to have muscles? We were arguing, okay, does it benefit a guy to have muscles or does it benefit him to not care about working out? I said, yeah, it matters. If a guy is strong, you know, he looks like he's capable, maybe he can, like, you know, help you move or, like, do other important athletic things. It helps for a guy to be strong.
I'm going to stop you right there because this revisionist history is an insult to the two of us.
It is an insult.
Your revisionist history, this is the point that was made. If you have a ton of money or other certain qualities and assets, you don't need muscles. That
is
a fact.
That is not what we were arguing.
Well, that's what we're discussing now, so.
Okay, so yes, it is far more important. It benefits everyone to have money, just like it benefits everyone for a guy to have muscles.
So money is most important to you.
Money is important.
You said it was way more important.
So is a personality, and so are muscles. None of which you have, Hookstead.
You can lose your looks. Dark things can happen to you for you to lose your personality and sense of humor. But
you
guess what?
You never lose your personality.
You got enough money in the bank. Live the lives the two of us have. I promise you that won't be true.
I've had lots of personality hits recently. Go ahead.
But you know what you won't lose? The bank account that provides security.
You can absolutely lose your bank
account.
If you're smart, no, you won't.
Right.
Now, if you you're
okay, but there are a lot of dumb rich people.
Yeah, and they don't stay rich. I'm talking about if you honestly think, if you are on an island of women, if you think I'd rather have a guy with big biceps than a guy.
If you're on a remote island with women, they do not care about your bank account.
Your idea is on an island. You're alone. Your idea is isolated.
No, you said an island of women.
Yes, that is a common saying.
And if you're on an island of women?
To say that
I've
your idea is on an island.
Before.
Okay, well, maybe it's just Midwestern slang for guys like the two of us. Point
maybe
remains.
It's people who don't know what they're talking about. And I'm telling you, if you were the only guy on an island, a remote island, with
your
thousands
idea.
Of women, they don't care how much money you have back in Manhattan.
A figment
they
of
care
speech
what
and
your biceps
literal.
Look like.
First off, I don't even have big biceps. I've never struggled to pick up anything I needed to pick up.
Other than women.
What do you mean pick up? See, what you're doing is you realize you have no argument and you don't want to admit what women truly want, which is security. That's fine. That's what biology and evolution has done to us. Money provides that for future generations, and you don't want to admit what we all know. Women care more about money than pretty much everything else.
Hookstead, do you think that she is in denial about her own feelings?
She's delusional.
Okay. I'm not delusional.
I've heard this young woman right here in this newsroom say both she needs a guy who makes a ton of money and is around her 24/7.
So yeah, 24/7, that's
so
true.
I don't
we actually
call
have
you
to
out.
Get an operation where we're attached to the hip. Okay, but let me just say this.
That sounds painful.
Can you explain? Can you explain why someone like, I don't know, Mark Zuckerberg or Jeff Bezos, they made their money, and once they had made it, they then got ripped because they realized, oh, maybe the money isn't doing it enough for me.
Zuckerberg's appearance has not changed in 15 years.
Zuckerberg is like relatively ripped.
Are you sure Jeff Bezos is ripped?
Yes. Have you seen that photo of him in the vest with the aviators?
Okay. Yeah, he's pretty ripped.
So they
never
made
mind.
Their money, and then they decided, oh, you
I
know
what? I
don't
know if they then decided to
maybe money's
ripped.
Not all it's cracked up
Look,
to be.
I can only...
Maybe I need, I don't know, some biceps to get better women.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure Mark Zuckerberg, the founder of Facebook, couldn't get laid if you didn't do push-ups.
I think...
screen. Do you really believe that Mark Zuckerberg would have an issue picking up any woman
any woman
he could literally
to.
Give it them $1 billion for a half hour and he still won't even know
what's
gone.
That's called prostitution. It's illegal in most states. But what I'm saying is that it probably helps if you're not only a billionaire, but also, I don't know, like, work out and have a nice body. That helps. It doesn't hurt.
Once you hit a threshold, it doesn't matter.
Yes, it does.
Why do
you
think,
are butt
hold on,
ugly.
Hold on. Why do you think rich women allow their men to cheat on them nonstop and they don't divorce them? Because they want the money line to continue.
Yes, but it helps.
Yes.
If you're getting a better caliber of woman, and it's just not going to hurt you if you are a billionaire and also ripped.
But I'm saying ultimately the money is what drives the
conversation. I don't think there's ever like a bell curve where it like cancels itself out. Like, oh, I'm so rich that I can just become a fat like piece of poop and not care about
anything. If you have $1 billion in the bank,
biology
women
still
will
comes
screw
into play.
You no matter what. You will not struggle to get laid.
Yeah, you can hire them or they might not be.
You don't even need to hire them. Because money drives influence.
Yes, but, if you take two billionaires and one of them is, like, really attractive and ripped and the other one is, like, not so attractive and ripped, the one who is attractive and ripped is always going to
win out.
But
what if the attractive and ripped guy has no sense of humor, no comedy in him, no personality, and the non-ripped one does?
Well,
you're cornered now, Hookstead.
Would you say that dad bods do more to appear to women? Appeal to women than
I think a dad bod signals stability, wisdom, cash in the bank, those type
cash
of things.
Cash in the bank.
What are your thoughts on dad bods, Jenna?
Because that's what dads have.
Yeah,
I do like dad bods. I will say, but there's a difference. Like, the whole thing with dad bods is you can still run a mile when you're hungover the next day. You still lift weights. You go to the gym and stuff.
I don't know about that.
Literally, the definition of dad bods is, like, somebody who, like, isn't super ripped, but, like, still works out and, like, tries a little bit.
I have a dad bod. I do not run when I'm hungover in the morning.
You have a noodle bod. I don't really think you have a dad bod.
I mean, you want me to get shirtless? We can right now.
We
let the audience decide.
Okay. If you go back to the original thesis about the dad bod, it's about a guy that doesn't care too much, but still tries. Like, he still goes to the gym, but he still likes to have a pizza and a few beers. It's
what
like
about a guy who does the prison workout and also drinks beer and eats pizza?
Well, do you have that billion? Like, how are
you? No, I'm saying, are you still a dad bod if instead of the gym you do the prison workout, which one of my fine coworkers introduced me to a few months ago, and it made me shredded as hell.
So then you shouldn't have any problem with women because you're shredded and you're apparently a billionaire.
I never said, whoa. I
have a great personality.
Hold on.
According to one woman in the office, have piercing blue eyes.
Facts? No, eyes that pierce women's souls is what
she
told me.
Okay, eyes that pierce women's souls.
When did I ever say I was rich?
A little invasive.
I never said I was rich. I have slummed it my whole life since day one, for the record. And that's contributed to the personality that, you know, has made me the man I am, that women just fall
for. So is this all really an argument about you, Hookstead? This isn't really about life and biology and women's preferences, which I think I would know something about women's preferences, maybe a little bit more than, say, you, a man. But is that really what
this
is all about?
Why would you say that?
It's all about, like, what you think women like about you and not about...
I know what women do and do not like about me. I'm a self-aware man. That might blow your mind, but I am shockingly self-aware. This has nothing to do with me. I'm just saying, as a practical man who grew up around women and knows women and knows what women go for, I've never seen a woman not smile when stacks of hundreds hit the floor. So I've seen women. I've seen women in a situation where a guy with a six pack walks through the door. Sometimes I don't even notice. You ever seen a woman see a bunch of money and not notice?
What are you talking about, Hookstead?
What Hookstead's saying is the dad bod implies that the man has other things to focus on.
Thank you.
Rest.
That is what I'm saying.
Okay.
It is more fulfilling. I don't know. I'm an unbiased moderator, but some people might say that it's more fulfilling to work than work out. That it is more fulfilling to complete a craft rather than glorify your own body.
Yeah, you don't have to do one and not the other. It helps if you do both.
Look, so, I would like to believe someday I will have enough money to where my wife likely won't have to work. Okay? She can spend all the time. She
I don't know, except we've gotten into many a discussion about how, women who don't work, like, blah, blah, blah.
I have feelings on that as well, which are also very, very, very strong. We can save that debate for another time. My point is this. If you have all the free time in the world and you already have money in the bank, feel free to work out. That makes sense. If you don't have money on the bank, work out by working your way to becoming a billionaire.
Why not do both?
Thank you.
Why not do both? Why not work so hard and set a half hour?
It's hard to find the time to go to the gym if you're really working.
No, 45 minutes.
I do the prison workout for that reason.
It's some people, you
and
know,
it's good
so
for your mental.
Hey,
health.
I tell you what, work. I tell you what, Jenna. I tell you what, we're gonna. This
tell
is
me
this.
What. Tell me what.
Here's a $20 bill. I will give you. You tell me right now. Actually, we'll even.
That's pretty enticing, Jenna.
Here's $40. Tell me.
Make it 60. Smiling, I'm not listening.
She's
until
smiling.
60.
She's smiling ear to ear. She sees money and she's smiling ear to ear.
Oh man.
There's a guy off screen who. There's two, three, four guys off screen who are pretty physically fit. Hey Jenna, what do you want
wait,
more?
Wait, can we talk about
you? Do you want a hug? Do you want a hug
fit?
From one of them, or do you want please. These two crisp $40 bills? Which appeals to you more?
Okay, but you know what I would rather have?
The money. Case closed.
No.
Can we talk about your driver's license picture, please?
Great ripped guys was offering me that, and you both were like, hey, honey, you want
they're
some money?
They're not, though. I am. Which is it?
All right. Can I get 60 from any of you guys? Like, come on. A credit card. Sold.
Debate over. When faced with the actual choice, she chose the money.
Right. Thank you, guys. Thank you.
Hey, do you believe in firing warning shots? Yeah, neither do I. Ammo's way too damn expensive. And besides the smoke room, we're shoot first, ask questions later.
Like and subscribe for more of that below.